Hello, I'm Ezekiel Dasho, and I'm going to do a quick sketch of this rhinoceros. I'm going to, it's basically this exercise, I'm just going to work on being as fast as I can with being as accurate as I can, and I'm still going to use the same principles that I've been using for the other drawings in terms of exercising restraint and not drawing a bunch of hard lines and so forth. So I'm starting with the head here, and what I'm basically doing is just roughing out the shapes, and it'll be very similar process-wise to the other videos. Where the shapes are readily apparent, I just press on, and when they're not, I just kind of see if I can find a way to work around them.
Are you going to draw that rhinoceros?
So right now, I need to look at the back of the rhinoceros and see if I can get the curvature there accurate to the there's a little bit of foreshortening going on here, and then we get down to its like tailbone here. It's these ridges here, and then I guess this rump curve here, and then that will go down to the legs, and the back right leg is a little bit in front, even so we got some dark shadowing there. Easy to kind of pick up this round shape from the belly, and shoulders, just like kind of front cuirass, like armor plated area in the front chest. Feet kind of do this little bit of a flaying thing there. And then it's the shape of this other leg where the rhinoceros is resting weight. That's kind of it. Now we're going to quick get in some of those spots where the shadow, like kind of draw some of the shadow lines. This ear up here is casting an unbelievable amount of shadow. Wow, it's totally believable. It's just a really long shadow, and it's casting over a good amount of the figure of the rhinoceros. And the eye here. Small and pretty close to the horn. And then we've got this shadow here. And a nostril coming down close to the lip. And let's see if we can get some of this other shadow in here. So the ear shadow, kind of just working from that, connects down here. And just for the sake of expediency, just speed's sake. There and do one of the angles of the cross hatching. I'm still not pushing hard, but we'll get to that in a minute here. And then this kind of just tapers the regularity of the rib cage, kind of tapers as it gets closer and it's not as foreshortened. the back leg's pretty dark, and then this one, the back left leg is even darker. It's a little bit lighter there, but I'm not going to worry about those plants and stuff. So, now that I've got my darker spots kind of singled out, I can just finish up with the belly and chest area. Going the other way with the cross hatching now. And then finally I'm going to go up, like straight up and down on these terminator lines. The lines where the shadow is darkest because the figure is, far, or that part of the figure is facing opposite of the light source. More character in those eyes, and let's darken up the ears. And so the horns are kind of these conical shapes, obviously, and those need their shadows in the right places. And getting close to finishing up here, you can go in and add some textures and that sort of thing. Definitely could benefit from detail and just had a few quick seconds for a video today, and I wanted to share something with you guys, and hopefully it's just sort of really quick sketch. I mean, it shows you how we get the basics done, and then from there you there's just any number of things you could do with it. Shade that in a little more. Definitely could really go for it with the detail and some of the wrinkles and curves and stuff like that. But I think what I'm going to do is just quick all the areas that are currently flat white. I'm just going to go over them very lightly so that they don't stand out as being completely flat. And so like this area on the head where I'm in, I don't have any of it colored in yet, or just do a little bit to make sure that it doesn't look too we've talked about this before too in the other drawing, in other videos, but just if it's by itself and it's plain white, it'll look very flat and very hot and bright, and that's fine if that's the look you want to go for. But for something like this, it'll just make the figure look like it's not kind of in its own world. So, get a little shadow here. Let's see if that's not coming through on the camera. Move it down a little bit. And that gives us a rough rhinoceros. And thanks so much. This has been Heezy Gildasho. And as always, I hope this was useful, and please don't hesitate to like and subscribe for more drawing videos on my channel. It's just exclusively videos about drawing, and maybe someday, you know, we'll do some watercolors or oils or something like that. But for now, it's just drawing, but it'll be exclusively like art how-tos and just demos and stuff like that. And basically just drawing together. And have a great day.